Pehme, editor-in-chief of City and State, and this is Last Look. Today, our guest is City and State columnist Bruce Gyory. Bruce, thanks for joining us again.
Always a pleasure. How are you?
I am well.
Good.
Your recent column talked about the Republicans' prospects in 2014.
Yes.
Do they have prospects in 2014?
Yes, but let me start with my bottom line, because I'm not a Republican, but I have great respect for what the Republican Party has done in this state, really from Dewey through Pataki. And my own belief is that when we have both parties actively engaged at the vital center of the electorate, we have better governance. So my advice is not na-na-na-na-na-na kind of, oh, here's a Democratic consultant. I believe it to my core. And I looked at certain things, and I saw four factors that I thought they had to kind of confront to do this. And the first factor is basically just gubernatorial cycles in New York have run in 16 to 20 year cycles, if you will, that presidential cycles tend to be 8 to 12. You know, one party has two terms, maybe three terms at best, and then out and you change parties. I mean, you look at it, three Dewey terms followed by the one Harriman term led to four Republican terms under Rockefeller, five Democratic terms under Kerry and Cuomo, and then three Pataki terms. So the Republican, if the Republicans are hoping for partisan fatigue of the Democrats after two election wins, the Spitzer win in 2006 and the Cuomo win, by the way, both landslides, one a record landslide, they don't have a lot of solace there.
So then, that's not a very encouraging factor.
No.
What are the other three better prospects?
No. Then there's kind of the political demographics. There's a 3.1 million registration advantage, 5.9 to 2.8 million. There is the fact that the Democrats are carrying New York City by 4-to-1 margins, and the old Republican registration advantages upstate and the suburbs have vanished. In those areas, the Democrats can run even and sometimes carry, although that's where the Republicans need to build. And then the third is women. Women are now 53% of the electorate in the last two elections, one gubernatorial, one presidential. The Republicans in New York have lost it 2-to-1. Then there's the minority growth. The minority vote was 29% of the electorate in 2010. In the aggregate, black plus Hispanic plus Asian plus multiracial, the Republicans lost it by over 4.5-to-1. As the census takes us towards that becoming a full third of the electorate, the Republicans are not going to have a prospect for winning unless they can get a full third of that minority third. And the final prospect is because of all these problems, there's not a statewide Republican elected, and they're missing what they always had. There was always a Dewey to define the New York Republican brand as opposed to Taft. There was the Rockefeller as opposed to the Nixon-Reagan. And there was the Pataki as opposed to the George W. Bush. Now, because there's no statewide Republican figure, the Republicans have been branded by kind of the Tea Party national movement, which doesn't suit well in New York. So now, this sounds pretty bleak, but Democrats were in this spot in the 70s and again in the 90s and bounced back. And what they had to do is stop talking to themselves. They had to confront the problem. So what do the Republicans have to confront? If they just try to be a small town rural pro-gun, pro-life party, they're going to miss where they really need to connect in the suburbs, and the fact they have to get up to 35% in the major urban centers like New York and like the thruway cities that run from Albany through Buffalo. They can do that. They've done it before. As recently as 2001 and 2002, George Pataki and Mike Bloomberg on the Republican line were running very strong with Hispanic and Asian voters, and Bloomberg even amongst black voters in 2005. It can be done, but that's hard work. If they just talk to themselves, like the Democrats did with Ramsey Clark and Bella Abzug, they're in big trouble. But I believe they can break out of that.
Yeah, I mean, that seems kind of like doom and gloom, though. And I mean, you know, what you're saying is consistent with what National Chairman Priebus was saying in his autopsy after
Yes.
the last election. And it seems like Chairman Cox has really taken strides to try to make inroads with minority voters. Do you see Republicans going in the right direction here, or is it,
they are saying the right things. They haven't yet been able to do the right things, but that doesn't mean they can't. And for instance, if they get a balanced ticket in 2014 with a strong candidate for governor who is articulating a message to a diverse number of New Yorkers, if they have different spots on the ticket showing that they have an active New York City person, a Hispanic, for some member of a minority group, and not just a token, but somebody who really is making a strong race and is grounded in that community, they can start to come around. But it's not easy work.
Are there any particular candidates who you think would be really standouts?
Garcia is intriguing. If he connects with Hispanic voters, as opposed to when the Republicans put up Dora Irizarry to run against Elliot Spitzer, and he swept the Hispanic vote as well as every other vote in 2002. So I don't know. Garcia is clearly someone that they have put a lot of hopes in. Let's see what else. I've heard some rumors that they're going to try to get a candidate who can marshal for governor, unnamed, who can kind of marshal that base vote. And I think that would be a mistake if they don't find somebody who can begin to build a bridge to the swing constituencies. And the swing constituencies now used to be their bedrock. It's carrying the suburbs of Long Island and Westchester and Rockland in the suburban communities around Syracuse and Albany and Rochester and Buffalo and the southern tier, and that's what they've been missing.
What about a candidate like Rob Astorino, who speaks Spanish? He represents Westchester, clearly a key area for the Republicans to win. I mean, does he have the kind of elements that would be necessary for
on a on paper? Yes, but I remember when the Republicans ran Andy O'Rourke, who I think spoke Spanish too, a popular county executive in Westchester, and he was the person who Mario Cuomo cleaned up on in 1986. I'm not saying Astorino can't. Let's see what kind of margin he comes out of his reelection with. Does he approach the 59% that he won the first time, or is he closer to 50%? That's one to keep an eye on this year. How does he do against Noam Branson?
You talked about how the Democrats bounced back from some dark times.
But it took a while.
I'm wondering if it could just go the other way and New York could become Massachusetts and the Republicans could be banished to utter obscurity.
I suppose it could. That part of me that likes the two-party system, and as I said at the beginning, likes when both parties are actively contesting at the vital center of the electorate, I hope not. I think it's better for governance if both parties are doing that. But if the Republican Party only talks to itself and doesn't come back to the center, then we could go the way of Massachusetts. As a New Yorker who values the bipartisan tradition, even though I'm perceived as a Democratic consultant, I hope that's not the direction the Republican Party goes in.
You know, one of the only positive lights for the Republican Party on the statewide level right now is the control over the state Senate. Do you see the Republicans holding on in 2014?
That will be a very interesting case, because if the marginal or swing races, as we politicians like to call it, or we political consultants, I'm not running for office, but we political consultants call it, are in those suburban districts. And if the top of the ticket is not talking to those swing districts, like Carl Paladino wasn't able to talk to those swing districts, they could have a problem. It will be very interesting. And it'll be very interesting too, do they continue to lose support and are dependent on Jeff Klein and that coalition, or can they actually contest to win a Republican majority outright? Huge question mark.
Yeah, a lot of Republicans have argued that, you know, that the Democrats got the bounce from President Obama being at the top of the ticket last time, this being an off year, that vote polling won't be a factor.
I'd make that argument if I were them. If those gains happen anyway. And I'll give you an example. Andrea Stewart Cousins came within 18 votes of beating Nick Spano in 2004. And then in 2006, everybody said, oh no, it's an off year. It's not gonna, Spano will win. And he lost that seat.
Yeah.
So we don't know. If they can't hold their key seats in an off-year election, then they really have problems. I'm not presuming they can't. They will make an impassioned argument that they're going to pick up seats. It'll be a very interesting question.
On that optimistic note, Bruce Gyory, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
And that's it for this episode of Last Look. For more episodes, please join us on the web at cityandstateny.com.